You are well on today. This is Pastor Hagwood, pastor of First Mountain Zion Missionary Baptist Church in Charlotte, North Carolina, where we are exalting Christ to restore, renew, and rebuild people to serve the kingdom of God. This is our hour of worship, virtual worship on this morning. I pray that you're well. I hope things are well with you. Just came out of our Sunday school hour about 30 minutes ago or so. And just thanking God for what we are about to experience in this hour of worship. I'm going to come back with some words a little later with regards to First Mount Zion Missionary Baptist Church, things that are going on and that we're doing and so forth as we proceed into the months to come. But before we go any further, I want to indoctrinate, consecrate this place, this area, this space in the midst of prayer, because it's only fitting and it's only right that we do so. Before I go into prayer, I want to communicate that everyone who does not have internet access, please text them and let them know that the conference call line is open at 978-990-5000. Once again, 978-990-5000. And the access code is 148924. 148924. And they can access the conference call line that way if they don't have internet access. Praise be to God on today. Let us go to the Lord in prayer together. Let us pray. The most eternal and all-wise God, our Heavenly Father, we thank you for this moment, Lord, as we go to you into this virtual place of worship. We ask right now in the name of Jesus that you lead us, guide us, motivate us, God. Help us in every way and allow us to see your glory even on today. Bless us now and keep us and allow us, Lord, just to see the manifestation of your glory as we proceed forward in faith. We love you, we praise you, we honor you, we thank you, Lord, for all that you continue to do. Bless us now and keep us. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. God's blessings to you. I've got some instrumental music queued up, and I'm going to play it at this time, and I'll be back for some announcements, First Mountain Zion, and also to local family here in Charlotte with regards to various things that are going on today. Amen. Hey Google, volume at 8. Thank you. Amen. We thank God on today for what God is doing in the midst of his people and how he continues to manifest his glory in and around about us on a regular basis. So with that being said, I want to go into the perspective of the certain announcements that I have, and these should be brief. Please remember First Mount Zion family, we have on next week our Friends and Family Day, which we're actually going to have. Let me give you the lineup again with regards to our Friends and Family Day. We will have Sunday school, which will actually be at 10. It'll be at 10 a.m. And then from there, it'll be virtually here as we always have right now for Facebook Live. So remember, at 10 a.m., it won't be at 8:45, it'll be at 10 a.m. So from 10 a.m. to 11, we'll have our virtual Sunday school, which we'll go ahead and have on Facebook Live. So please come to our site on Facebook and you'll be able to see our lesson for that day and hear and participate also in that lesson for that day. From 12 p.m. to 2 p.m. On the campus, we will have actually our silent auction that will be going on. We're going to get the logistics out to you this week. I've got to talk to all the heads of the missionary ministry in order to make sure that we can get that out to everybody of how that's going to be orchestrated. We are, of course, practicing social distancing in the midst of the pandemic. I just don't know what rooms right now that we're going to allow folks to actually walk through. If it's going to be just the fellowship hall or if we're going to use the long hallway in the back of the church in order to conduct the silent auction. But it will happen again from 12 p.m. to 2. This is on next Sunday. Remember, October 25th, Friends and Family Day. So 10 a.m. to 11, Sunday school virtually, Facebook Live. And then we'll have from 12 p.m. to 2 p.m., we will have the silent auction, okay, that will be going on at the church. Okay, also, again, at 2:30 will be the actual outside worship experience. So please be in prayer for an awesome, glorious day outside. We will have bring everything outside. The preacher, myself, Pastor Hagwood, will be preaching. I'll be on probably some apparatus or something that allow me to be lifted so people can see me in order to be able to preach. Okay, I'm going to ask, I'll probably call Emmanuel Wilson this week because I know man has been dealing with a lot of stuff here lately, and we need to work out the logistics with regards to just the electrical pieces and so forth to get everything outside. I'm going to ask for the praise team, please be on standby to sing. In order to conduct worship again outside, and I'm thinking that service again will be probably about an hour or so as we go through the process of that worship. It'll happen at 2:30 p.m. We'll have cars will be distant, socially distanced, and you can sit outside of your car if you have a chair, okay? But that's the only place you can set a chair up. We will not have a lot of inflow, outflow out of the church because of the pandemic. We won't have that. More than likely, we'll probably have the restrooms available for folks who need to use them and so forth. And then, of course, for the silent auction, there'll be a one-way in and a one-way out situation with regards to that. But that will be the only traffic going through the aspect of the sanctuary and of the building because we want to keep everyone safe. And after we're done, our Friends and Family Day will conclude. Of course, we will have the aspect of service, prayer, and so forth during that day. It's going to be an awesome day. Just continue to pray for good weather. I'm looking at weather reports now, just praying to God that next Sunday, we will have, there'll be a good day that we can go out, be outside, and worship. Again, we have not gathered together since mid-March. And it'll be good to see everyone again that can come. Again, there'll be probably individuals flowing traffic because we've got to keep cars socially distanced and so forth. But we are going to go with the Friends and Family Day in this manner, okay? So please, ma'am, please, sir, have your mask, have sanitizer. We will have sanitizer, of course, at the church. And again, we will have a worship experience for Friends and Family Day on next Sunday, a week from today. So God's blessings to you in that regard. Please keep in mind the announcements. We'll have more details this week. I did not put a call post out this week, which I probably should have. We've got some things that are coming up, but I wanted to mention this on our virtual worship with regards to Friends and Family Day. And you'll definitely be hearing more about it this week, because I'll probably put a blurb at least twice, maybe three times, on the call post, so that members will know what's going on, and probably even more details than what I'm giving you even right now. Please mark this on your calendar. October 31st, 1 p.m. to 4 p.m., we're having Trunk or Treat. We're probably going to have about 7 cars socially distanced, where the kids can come and be prepackaged candy that we're actually going to put up in Ziploc bags and be able to hand out to kids, of course, during this season that we're in. So that will go on the 31st, we'll go on October 31st from 1 p.m. to 4 p.m. So it's the afternoon hours where we will actually have the Trunk or Treat. And our youth department is handling that. Sister Ware is putting everything, getting everything together in regards to that. We are taking donations for candy. Please get those to the church as quickly as possible. So, because there's work to be done to prepackage everything and to make sure it's available on the 31st. Also, October 28th, I'm asking for all ministries, and this will be a part of calling posts as well, all ministries to have your leaders for 2021 into the church by October 28th, okay? The reason why we're doing this is because we're going to push forward toward also another date I want to give you, November 21st. November 21st is when we'll have our annual church meeting. It will be virtual. We will have it via Zoom and conference call line. So mark that down, November 21st, 2 p.m. November 21st at 2 p.m. We will have our annual church meeting virtually on Zoom. We'll get the address to you, Zoom address to you, as well as on our conference call line where you can actually call in as well for that. And again, October 28th, we want to get the leaders for the ministries, the leaders for 2021. The only exception at this point is the trustee ministry. So things being explained there, we'll get that out to you. But that's the only ministry that doesn't have to submit anything. But the other ministries of the church, please submit your leaders for 2021. If you need to use the conference call line in order to meet with your ministries, you may do so, but we have to schedule that accordingly, or find another means by way you can meet virtually. Again, Zoom happens to be, especially if you technologically have the capacity to do so, Zoom helps out a lot from the perspective of being able to meet. And a lot of my meetings here lately, both church-related, have been on Zoom. Okay, so please, I would ask, encourage you to do that, to use Zoom. The app, I think it's free on your phone, your phones and your computer, and be able to use it that way in order to communicate and then to get those lists into the church. We do need them by October 28th, so that gives you about a week and a half to go through that process. So please, ma'am, please, sir, go through that process of getting those names for leaders. Again, except for exception of the trustee ministry, all other ministries of the church auxiliaries should get their leaders' names into us by October 28th. You'll be hearing more about that on calling posts as well. So those are the announcements that, again, I have. Friends and Family Day, again, October 28th, with regards to getting ministry leaders into the church, and then also the names of ministry leaders into the church, and then also November 21st, which will be at 2 p.m., which will be our annual church meeting virtually, and we'll get those addresses for Zoom out to you, and also on the conference call line. It'll be on the conference call line. So God's blessings again to everyone. I pray again that you're well on today. Again, this is our time of giving. And I've been having problems, fortunately, with my Givelify app, because I can't give like I would like to on the course of today. So that means I probably have to refresh my phone or something, but we'll get that done. Remember, from 1 p.m. to 3 p.m. today, you can go by the church and actually give your tithes and offerings. That's both on Saturday and Sunday. So please keep in mind there will be someone at the church to get your tithes and offerings on both of those days, 1 p.m. to 3 p.m. today. You can head by the church and actually give your tithes and offerings. You can always mail them to the church, 1515 Remount Road, Charlotte, North Carolina, 28208. Also, by way of Givelify, the Givelify app on your phone, you can look us up there and actually give by way of Givelify on our website at www.firstmountzion, that's FirstMountZion.com. Just go to the homepage, hit the donate button in the upper right-hand corner. That'll lead you to the PayPal app, and you can give by way of credit card or debit card that way. So you can give by way of PayPal that way from our website. And again, from all the other places I've mentioned, if you need to contact the church, please do. If you're locally, 704-332-8335. Contact the church. If you need someone to come pick up your tithes and offerings and no one answers, just leave a message and we'll get back to you and make sure we can have someone come by your home or your residence and actually pick up your tithes and offerings locally here in the Charlotte area. Just please feel free to contact the church in that manner. So with that being said, I want to have a word of prayer before we go into this time of giving. I ask that you again give unto the Lord as the Lord sees fit. Again, the Lord loves a cheerful giver. So with regards to that, make sure that we are giving to the church, because in order for ministry to proceed and move forward and the things that we do in ministry for Jesus Christ, you must contribute and give to the house. You must contribute and give to God's house in order that we can continue to do the ministry of Jesus Christ as a church body of First Mount Zion. Let's have a word of prayer, and I'm going to cue up another instrumental for you as we move forward in faith. Let us pray. Father God, we thank you and praise you, Lord, for today. Thank you, Lord, for continuing to bless us and keep us, God, in every shape, fashion, and form. During this time of giving, oh God, ask, oh God, that there are many individuals who are seeking, God, various things, God. In the midst of a pandemic, people have been laid off, furloughed, and things of that nature, oh God. They're looking for a blessing, Lord. And Lord, in the midst of this time of worship, that we want to encourage them, God, to understand that it's by way of worship that we're able, oh God, to do the things that we do in ministry, to give, help the poor, disenfranchised, and the disinherited. And God, we ask right now, Lord, that even where we are right now, that we give to you, Lord, and we give unto the ministry, so that, Lord, your ministry goes forward, that your word continues to be preached and taught, so that, Lord, we are becoming more stewards of your word, but also doing the things according to the standards of your word that you have asked. So God, we ask right now, Lord, that we give cheerfully and regularly to our ministry so that, Lord, we can continue to move forward in your name. We love you and praise you in all things. Bless this giving time, because God, you're going to bless it for sure and help us, oh God, along the journey to appreciate the aspect not only of giving, but also the blessings that come behind it, oh God, of us being able to receive because of your goodness and your mercy. Thank you, Lord, for all things. In Jesus' name we pray and ask all. Amen. God's blessings to you. I want to cue another song up, then we'll come back for our scripture reading on today. Hey, Google. Cue up Black Instrumental Worship music.
Okay, 3 hours of soaking in his presence.
Hey Google, please play Black Instrumental Gospel music.
Sure, check out this instrumental Black Gospel music station on YouTube Music.
Hey Google, turn the volume to zero. Hey Google, turn the volume to 8. Mm-hmm. Amen. Our scripture for today actually comes from the Gospel of John, the Gospel of John, chapter number 4. And I'm going to read verses 31 through 42. Gospel of John, chapter 4, verses 31 through 42. And I'm reading from the New International Version of God's Word, and this is what it says. It says, "Meanwhile, his disciples urged him, 'Rabbi, eat something.' But he said to them, 'I have food to eat that you know nothing about.' Then his disciples said to each other, 'Could someone have brought him food?' 'My food,' said Jesus, 'is to do the will of him who sent me, to finish his work. Don't you have a saying, it's still 4 months until harvest? I tell you, open your eyes and look at the fields. They are ripe for harvest. Even now, the one who reaps draws a wage and harvests a crop for eternal life, so that the sower and the reaper may be glad together. Thus the saying, one sows and another reaps, is true. I sent you to reap what you have not worked for. Others have done the hard work, and you have reaped the benefits of their labor. Many of the Samaritans from that town believed in him because of the woman's testimony. He told me everything I ever did. So when the Samaritans came to him, they urged him to stay with them, and he stayed 2 days. And because of his words, many more became believers. They said to the woman, 'We no longer believe just because of what you said. Now we have heard for ourselves, and we know that this man is really the Savior of the world.'" May the Lord add a blessing to the reading of his holy word. May it sanctify to the deepest roots of our heart. Amen. At this time, I want to play, amen, another song. And afterwards, I will come with the preach word of God.
Tonight's dinner?
Hey Google, turn volume to 0. Hey Google, turn volume to 8.
Thank you.
we thank God on today, amen, for what we have seen and heard, even in this moment in time, amen. The word of God has been read, but at this time, the word of God needs to be preached, amen. I ask that you please bear with me on this sermon topic and sermon title on this morning. Out of John chapter 4, verses 31 through 42, again, I've read the scripture, and the title of the sermon this morning is, again, the harvest is always now. The harvest is always now. The harvest is always now. Church, many of us have heard the saying, there is no better time than the present to get things done. Maybe some of us have heard it said through the choral lyrics of a rocker by the name of Lenny Kravitz. Baby, it ain't over till it's over. There are thunderstorms that happen and they never end when we think that they should. Some of you have been watching the World Series, and now Game 7 has come up with the Atlanta Braves and the Los Angeles Dodgers. And so with that, there will be a finishing touch to that athletic event leading up towards whoever wins that game goes to the World Series. And with this, I think that when we look at the aspect of sporting events at times and other things that we see in life, that there's always the aspect of competition, something, one agenda competing against another in order to come to some level of fruition, to something greater than what was there before, because some level of fight had to happen in order to get to an everlasting outcome. Truly, think about this, First Mount Zion and Virtual Family, fighting for our families in hopes that they will have more opportunities than we had. Fighting year after year against the ills of a society that brands racial and social equality as some form of weakness and attempts to keep certain groups of people from attaining the necessities to live, thrive, and prosper. Let me keep going. Fighting at every moment just to speak our minds on why we wage war before waging dialogue, why we first propose violence rather than intellectual vigilance, and why we are more apt to subject other people's feelings to hurt and anguish rather than to help and give assistance. And today, church, I watch the idiot box called the TV and see the dumbing down and buffoonery of the country we live in by prospective future leaders who are intellectually challenged, ethically unsound, and morally distant. I view a postmodern and a non-altruistic world and wonder where the spirit of Big Mama went that would seek God first for the answers to questions she could not answer, rather than many people saying God doesn't exist and then wondering why their answers are the mistakes we have to dig ourselves out of. You have to excuse me again, church, virtual church, but I am seeing various circumstances in our communities that should not be occurring amongst people who are supposed to be civilized. We live in a civilized world, society, but there are people under the sound of my voice working full-time jobs but still can't afford to live with the pay they bring home. Restaurants throw away tons of prepared food every day while there are families hungry in the streets of Charlotte, in the streets of Dallas, in the streets of Houston, Texas. And we as the church, not just First Mount Zion, but the church universal, are doing all that we can to reach people with the word of Christ by the way of the acts of Christ. Well, Pastor, what are you speaking of? It's not what I'm speaking of, but it is what Jesus spoke of when he made proclamation, for I was hungry and you fed me not. I was thirsty and you gave me nothing to drink. I was a stranger and you did not invite me in. I needed clothes and you did not clothe me. I was sick and I was in prison and you did not come and see about me and look after me. And this is the reason I stand before you this morning with yet another message concerning the good news of Jesus Christ. So many of us have time for whatever we wish to make time for. Yes, I understand you have to go and go to the grocery store and go to Walmart and get your groceries and get the things that you need. And see, we make time for that. We make time to sit down and watch athletic events, to watch an NBA finals, to watch Major League Baseball. We make time for that. We make time to make sure that we are watching Power and watching Power Goes 2 and all the other programs on TV. See, we make time to do and to have all those. See, we make time to go to the mall and to shop and to do the things that we want, to go to Dick's Sporting Goods and to go to Academy Sports and all these other places because there are certain things that we want. So for the things that we want, we make time for. We make time to be with our honey boo, honey drop, dew drop. We make time for romantic excursions and being with people that we love. See, we make time for that because we deem it as important. We make time to go and to have fun, to go down to the beach at Charleston, to go down to other places and to be able to follow amongst our friends and our loved ones. We make time for those things because we deem those things as important. We had time again to do household chores because the floor needed to be swept. The floor needed to be vacuumed. We had to get dinner on the table. We had to fire the stove up to get something cooked. Those things were important, so we made time for those things. And we even have time in order to be able to get to the virtual space this morning to come and to listen to God's word. We make space and we make time for those things. So with that, but within all the time that we had to perform duties and tasks that we deemed as important, was there any mention of Jesus Christ to the people that we came in contact with? Was Jesus mentioned when you paid for that gas and that fountain drink at Quick Trip? Was Jesus mentioned when you and the cashier were talking in the line at Walmart? Did you invite the mechanic who did your oil change to worship, virtual worship? When you got your hair did, and you can still get your hair did, or get your hair cut, did you invite someone to the space of virtual worship on this morning? While we were at all these places, did we give place of Jesus forefront to invite someone into our space? And I'm not being boisterous, but the example that Jesus set in our text this morning is one that we have the opportunity to initiate in every facet of life. There's a commercial that says a sandwich just isn't a sandwich without the spread of Miracle Whip on it. And this can also be said of us this morning. A church just isn't a church without the spread of the gospel done outside of it. And the spread of the gospel is good at all times. And the retrieval of souls that are saved by the spread of the gospel is also good at all times. The salvation of souls in Jesus Christ is the business that we as the body of Christ are in all the time. And I want to deal with the question as the Holy Spirit will allow me on this morning. Why is the harvest always now? Why is the harvest always now? Well, church, the harvest is always now because we as Christians can eat more than what we are currently eating. Let me say that again. Because we as Christians can eat more than what we are currently eating. Virtual church. After Jesus had told the Samaritan woman everything she had ever did, his disciples encouraged him to eat something. Now, to understand this, we must remember that Jesus had sent his disciples into a town in Samaria called Sychar to buy food. Well, the disciples are back with the food and encourage Jesus to eat. Jesus then responds to them in verse 32 and says, I have food to eat that you know nothing about. The disciples thought that someone may have brought Jesus some food. However, Jesus was speaking of something that was deeply and purely spiritual. And you see, virtual church in First Mount Zion, physical food will sustain the body, but spiritual food provides substance and sustainability to both the body and the soul. Church, please don't get so caught up on chicken, red beans, and rice, two of the sides and a biscuit, and some sweet tea as your journey through life. Even Jesus had to tell Satan from the archives of the Old Testament, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God. And this, my friends, is what God is telling us on today. God is saying that we have to eat more than what we are currently eating. Right now, I hope you realize that you are eating right now. I know that there's an aspect of you going down to Londa's place or some other soul food establishment after you deal with the pastor during virtual worship on today. And I understand you're going to get your eat on at that place. But I need for you to get your feel on this word of God on this morning. Go ahead and eat it up and clean off your plate. Before you leave the aspect of the virtual service this morning, I encourage you to grab a few to-go plates, okay, of the word of God. Box it up and take it into your home and allow your family to eat. Take it to your job and share it with your coworkers, your boss, and anyone there who needs to feast on the word of God. Take it to places that you go every single day and let them eat of the word of God. Take it to your frat brothers and your sorority sisters and allow them to feast on the joy that gives you strength. Take it when you go shopping. Take it when you go on vacation. Take it on your next business trip. Take it to you and take it on Thanksgiving. Take it on Christmas. Take it when the people want it and take it when they don't want it. But anyway, take it wherever you go, because everybody at some point has to eat the word of God. First Mount Zion, I need for you to box it up and feed God's people. Church, you eat more of this word by taking it from this place virtually and feeding everyone else. What benefit am I to you if I have something good that I decide not to share with you? My second point this morning, why is the harvest always now? Because, church, we have to reap that which we did not sow. Because we have to reap that which we did not sow. Jesus goes on later in the text, tells his disciples that the harvest is ripe right now for this season. You must yield that which you did not plant. In First Mount Zion, our church is about 92, 93 years old. Some of us this morning have been planting spiritual seed in our community of faith for a long time. However, there is more wheat ready to be pulled than seed has already been planted. The point Jesus is making is very, very clear. There are full stalks of people right here on the virtual space that God is ready to use right now. But the church, from pulpit to pew in this space, has always been in the mode of reaping harvest for that which we may not have planted. I want you to think, for 90-some years old, leaders have come through First Mount Zion and have planted seeds for decades. And now, in the midst of where we are, we have seeds that have already been planted, But now there is harvest, fruit, vegetable, and whatever else that's grown up. And now it's time for us who are here now to pull those stalks up so that we can eat and so that others can share in the goodness of God. Because we're reaping what we did not sow. And as Jesus said, others have done the hard work. And now it is time for us to reap the benefits of their labor. My third point, why is the harvest always now? Because, church, we never know the blessing of people the church is going to get. So before I end the sermon on this morning, Jesus has a few more things to tell us from this text on this morning. The Bible says that after the testimony of the Samaritan woman, many of the other Samaritans urged Jesus to stay with them, and he stayed for 2 days. Within those 2 days, Jesus preached the word of God, and many more were saved in amongst the Samaritans. And first Mount Zion, I believe that the mother of Forrest Gump was right. Life is like a box of chocolates. You never know what you're going to get. And verse Mount Zion, the world is like a box of chocolates, and the church doesn't know what it's going to get. It may get drug users, and it may get drug dealers. It may get alcoholics, and it may get adulterers. It may get people with misdemeanors, and it may get folks with felonies. It may get corporate businessmen, and it may get white-collar criminals. It may get former gang members, and it may get current gang members. But not only that, it may get an atheist, and it may get an agnostic. It may get an abuser, and it may get a chronic liar. It may get a professional athlete, and it may get freshman college students. It may get a searching mechanic, and it may get the cashier at Walmart. It may get that attendant working at Carowinds, and it may get that associate working at North Lake Mall. But whoever the church gets, always remember that the church has to go get them. The harvest is now. Go get your friend. Go get the co-worker. Go get the college freshman. Go get your enemy. Go get the drug dealer. Go get the mechanic. Go get and go get and go get anybody that you come in contact with. Everyone does not know Jesus. Everyone who doesn't know Christ, go and get them, because the harvest is always now. May God bless you. May heaven smile upon you. Remember, the harvest is always now. Even in the pandemic, there are folks that are searching, and you have spiritual food to give them. Think you have nothing to offer. You have plenty. If you are a child of God, there's people that are searching. They've been trying to find answers in everything and can't find them. And now, in a pandemic, they're looking for answers. And the answer has always been the same. Jesus Christ our Lord. Find Jesus while he is still able to be found. The harvest is always now. Get your harvest. Refuel. Feed up. Eat up. But also share. Share the goodness of the Lord with everyone that you meet. The salvation power of Jesus that we continue to live, that gives us life full and free, and allows us to see his glory each and every day. God's blessings to you. May God bless you. May heaven smile upon you. I'm going to cue up one more song, and I'm going to come back for our benediction on today. Hey, Google, play Black Instrumental Worship.
Sure. Here's a YouTube music playlist called Black Gospel Instrumental Worship.
Hey Google, turn the volume to zero. Hey Google, turn the volume to 8. Amen. May God bless you. May heaven smile upon you. I pray that the message today will surely be a lamp unto your feet and a light unto your path as God continues to manifest his glory inside and outside of you. First Mount Zion family, keep in mind all the announcements that we have mentioned. Remember that you can always give to the church at any time during the course of the week. As far as tithes and offerings are concerned, please do so. Amen. In support of the ministry. We thank God on today for all that we have seen and all that we have heard in the midst of our message and so forth on today. God's blessings again to you. I did forget one announcement that is UMBA related. Souls to the Polls. Souls to the Polls is going on today at 2 p.m. at Ramir Bearden Park in Uptown Charlotte. And it's basically a march to the polls. So I'm giving you this announcement, but also the standpoint of making sure, First Mount Zion family, that you are voting. Okay? We're in a voting season. Your pastor has already voted. I voted on the first day of early voting, which was this past Thursday, if I'm not mistaken, on the 15th of October. And I've already voted. I suggest that you do the same. I know many others have. I saw Sister Melissa Adams. I had early voted at a precinct, and I think I saw a few other members who had gone out to vote. Please, ma'am, please, sir, it is imperative on this election season that you vote. If you are having problems voting, let me fill you in on something that you may not know. If you are not registered to vote, the deadline has passed on October 9th, but a lot of people don't know this, what I'm about to tell you. October for early voting through the 31st, if you are not registered to vote and you go to early voting, okay, you go to early voting, you can register to vote on that day and vote that same day. A lot of folks don't know that. Fill that in with your family and friends because it's important. You can still register. So go to the polls and go actually in. Bring a form of ID. Definitely a driver's license or something of that nature, because they have to have that in order to get all your information. But with regards to that, you can go and vote. You can actually get in line, register to vote, and after you've registered, you can actually go in and vote. So that'll happen all the way through October 31st. You can't vote on election day on November 3rd. However, you can still vote if you're not registered. You just go to the polls and you'll get registered. You'll get registered to vote, and then you'll be able to vote in the early voting, even though the October 9th deadline has already passed. A lot of people don't know that. Please communicate that, because that's very important for those who may not be registered to vote in North Carolina post the October 9th deadline. You can still get registered if you go to an early voting precinct or site and get registered to vote and actually vote that same day. So with that being said, souls to the polls, 2 p.m. At Ramir Bearden Park in Uptown Charlotte. God's blessings to you. Thank you, First Mount Zion. Love you in the Lord. There's nothing you can do about that. I'm going to continue to love on you as your pastor. Again, I'm Pastor Sean Hagwood, pastor of First Mount Zion Missionary Baptist Church, where we are exalting Christ to restore, renew, and rebuild people to serve the kingdom of God. Let's look to the Lord to be dismissed from the virtual space on today. Let us pray. Father God, we thank you for this worship experience that we've had on today. We ask, Father, that you bless us and keep us and give us what we need on the journey of life. Bless us, Lord, as we continue to move forward and always knowing that the harvest is always right now. Bless us now and keep us, and allow us to see your glory, O God, during the course of the day and throughout the week, if it be your will. Amen. Let us go. Thank you, Lord, for all again that you continue to do. Now may the grace of God and the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit rest, rule, and abide with us henceforth, now, and forevermore. And the people of God said, amen for the Father, amen to the Son, and amen for the Holy Spirit. God's blessings to you. Again, we are First Mount Zion Missionary Baptist Church, exalting Christ to restore, renew, and rebuild people to serve the kingdom of God. God's blessings to you. Have a blessed day on today, First Mount Zion and virtual family. Take care and be blessed.